On the 18th of October, the 193 members of the UN will vote on who will take up five non-permanent seats on the Security Council. Australia is estimated to have already spent around $25 million on its bid for one of those seats, while Prime Minister Julia Gillard and Foreign Minister Bob Carr are both now in New York trying to rally support. But does Australia deserve a seat on the Security Council, and selfishly, are there any benefits? Tom Switzer is a researcher with the U.S. Studies Centre at the University of Sydney, and he joins me at the desk. Right. Tom, good morning. How important is it for Australia to get a seat on the Security Council, even if it is for a two-year term?
Yeah, well, this bid is a brainchild of Prime Minister Kevin Rudd in 2008, and his goal was that a bid on the UN Security Council would make Australia a more creative middle power in the region and across the globe. And his successor, Prime Minister Gillard, Senator Carr, as you say, they're in New York right now. Their argument is this will enhance Australia's diplomatic leverage and improve Australia's credibility and prestige, which are very useful supplements to power in the world.
Now, the UN is often referred to as the toothless tiger. Might Australia not be better spent with time and effort and money being part of regional groups rather than the UN?
Well, very good point. I think there's a strong argument to be made there. Bear in mind that the United Nations was created in 1945, and one of the main criticisms of the UN today, or at least the Security Council, is that it's very much focused on Western Europe primarily, and yet there's been a huge shift of power economically towards our part of the world, and so it might make more sense for Australia to focus more on building those regional coalitions in Asia.
Well, Asia and the Asia-Pacific specifically don't have a lot of representation, especially on the Security Council. How important would it be for America to have a friend like Australia on that seat?
Well, very important. You may recall when President Obama came to Canberra last year, he made it quite clear that US foreign policy in the next 10 years will pivot away from the Middle East and focus more on East Asia. Now, of course, America has very close strategic alliances in Japan, South Korea, but Australia is also one of its most important non-NATO allies, and so it would make sense for Australia to be on the UN Security Council. Bear in mind, though, Ron, this is only for 2 years and it is rotational.
Well, down through the decades, Australia has had a lot of involvement with the Security Council, and it's always been politically bipartisan, but in this particular case, the coalition, the opposition, is against our taking up this seat. How will that influence the vote?
It won't influence the vote, but bear in mind the coalition takes a more bilateral position on international relations, whereas the Labor Party traditionally places more emphasis on the multinational process. In 1996, Paul Keating made a bid for the United Nations Security Council, but Australia lost to Portugal and Sweden. The Prime Minister John Howard and his Foreign Minister Downer weren't all that upset. In fact, in 2004, John Howard and Alexander Downer ditched any kind of bid because it costs a lot of money. It's $25 to $40 million, and it's not altogether clear how much power and influence Australia will yield on such an unruly body.
I got the idea, though, in that particular year, in that particular case, that the Howard government was worried about how they would have to compromise their foreign policy to suit UN policy. Is that something we would have to consider again? Do we have to compromise to their rules?
Well, look, there is a great debate, and many prominent diplomats, such as Dick Woolcott, who was a UN ambassador for many years, have argued that this is a bit like the gravy train that you see leading up to host cities or candidates for host cities in the Olympics trying to woo the International Olympic Committee, you know, with cocktails parties and almost a form of a diplomatic checkbook diplomacy.
Yeah.
So there are real questions about how much influence and prestige Australia will have. As I say, the most important body is the permanent body, that is the United States, Russia, China, France and Britain. They really make the big calls. These other 10 countries are bid players only for 2 years.
Very, very briefly, are we going to get the seat?
It all depends on Africa. They have 50 seats, 50 states in the United Nations General Assembly. It will come down to them. Finland will get in. They've run a slicker campaign. But look, Finland has a good chance. And Luxembourg has a good chance because they've been around now for 10 years making this bid, whereas Australia's has only been there for 2008.
Johnny come lately.
Johnny come lately.
All right, Tom. Thank you very much. Tom
Thanks,
Switzer, who is with the US Studies Centre at the University of Sydney.